Окей. Питер. Привет,
yes.
Петя.
Привет.
So,
can you hear me?
Yes, yes, perfectly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's our pleasure to introduce next speaker, Peter Yuditskii. He is now in Austria, and he will speak about Remez inequality, pointwise Remez inequality. Please.
Many thanks to organizers. This paper is a joint work with Benjamin Eichinger, and this paper was dedicated to Alexander Aptekarev, an excellent mathematician and an extremely kind person. Remez inequality among the best known inequalities, and I will recall it mainly to introduce my notations. Let Pn denote the set of polynomials of degree at most n for a closed set E subset of the interval minus 1, 1. We denote by Pn of E the collection of polynomials of Pn such that they are bounded by 1 on absolute value on the set E. So the Remez problem is to find the given here supremum. And in our words, we are looking for the biggest possible value of a polynomial if it is bounded on the interval minus 1, 1, if it is bounded on the set E of the Lebesgue measure 2 minus 2 delta. Now, according to Remez, this biggest value can be expressed in terms of Chebyshev polynomial at a certain fixed point. Vladimir Andreevskii on several conferences raised the question how looks like this maximum, possible maximum, in the case when we first fix a point x0 inside in the interval minus 1, 1. So we are looking for value Ln given and the supremum of the biggest possible value of polynomial at the given point if we know that polynomial is bounded on a subset of minus 1 of the length 2 minus 2 delta. Now clearly the supremum of all possible x0 is mn delta, Remez constant. So Andreevskii asked about pointwise Remez inequality. And according to himself, this problem was motivated by previous results of Erdely, Saf, and himself. Evident remarks. Two evident remarks. Well, first of all, clearly that value we are interested in is even as a function of x0, so we assume that x0 is always less than 0. And let us consider case that delta is sufficiently small, no, let's say less than 1/2, and consider x0 equals 0. Then what we can say about the Remez classical polynomial, extremal polynomial, it is a Chebyshev polynomial related to the set minus 1 plus 2 delta 1. And therefore, for the given contraction constraint on delta, this polynomial is at most one on the at the origin. On the other hand, if we will consider so-called Achiezer polynomial, Achiezer polynomial is a polynomial with the least deviation on the two symmetric interval minus one minus delta delta one. Then such polynomial in the origin definitely greater than one. So we can see that. Question is indeed non-trivial, and moreover, extremal polynomial definitely depends on the position x0. So this is our main result to formulate. Let us make some introduce some notations. We will consider a system of two intervals with the gap alpha minus delta alpha plus delta. So this is interval gap is of the length 2 delta, and it is centered at the point alpha. To this set, we associate domain omega, see without E, And then they consider the green function with respect to infinity in this domain. So this is certain non-negative function on this gap interval. Now, our theorem, let us define the upper envelope of all possible such thing, then alpha is running in such a way that our gap is always inside interval minus 1, 1. Then the following asymptotic relation holds. So our value behaves asymptotically like n times this function phi delta of x0 plus possibly some constant, uniformly bounded value in m. Such summation are called usually totic Wiedemann bound. Now, so asymptotic behavior in problem is described by this upper envelope. A few words about this upper envelope. In fact, this is not upper envelope of infinitely many curves, but of just two curves. One of these curves can be given explicitly, and another curve can be given in certain parametric way. And we should take into account a Chiesser kind extremal polynomial asymptotically. So a Chiesser kind polynomial are extremal if x0 in this region, and starting from this Remez kind polynomial are extremal. So I call this Chebyshev-Chiesser diagram, and we should take into account a Chiesser case starting as soon as delta is smaller than some fixed value, which is indeed approximately 0.5. Okay, and more precise about this upper envelope, this is the following lemma. If we introduce this function, which is upper envelope of the Green function, then supremum, if a supremum at the given point x0 is attended at some internal point for a major alpha, then this x0 should satisfy this equation. And the only non-trivial statement here is that such equation has a unique solution. Otherwise, it is attended as delta approach, alpha approach to the end point. And in this case, we have explicit formula for upper envelope. And this is nothing but the Green function of the complement of the interval minus one plus two delta one. So we have these two curves. One is given explicitly, and another is a parametric curve given in terms of parameter alpha. Now, steps in the proof of this claim. The main first step deals with the parametrization of Chebyshev polynomial on subset of the interval minus 1, 1. And then the main part of the proof deals with reduction to a single gap in E. So the main part is to show that the extremal configuration is related to the set E, which has just a single gap on the interval minus one, one. And after that, we can discuss how to get asymptotic behavior of this value as n tends to infinity. And going back to the parametrization of Chebyshev polynomial, this I can call like Kharkov's edition of Chebyshev theorem. And we have here this nice interrelation between two objects of the conference, approximation theory and complex analysis. So in fact, Chebyshev polynomial can be parametrized in terms of conformal mapping on a special domain. Such domain are called n-regular comp, and n-regular comp, by n-regular comp, we mean a half strip with a system of slits. These slits has as a base points of the form pk, and they have certain height, which we denote by hk, And in some cases, which HK in principle can degenerate, so for some J, HJ is zero. So this is by definition, so this is half strip with a system of slits. And the fact is that if you consider conformal mapping of the upper half plane on such comb domain and consider cosine theta of Z, we will get a polynomial of degree exactly n. And the behavior of this polynomial is like this. If our value is on the base of the comb, then it's alternate between plus and minus one. And as soon as the value Z is on a slit, such polynomial is bigger than one. And this is mainly due to Achiezer that we can restate alternance theorem of Chebyshev in terms of the conformal mapping on such comb domain. Assume that H0 slit related to point zero is positive, and we denote by A and B preimages of point zero in our conformal mapping. Okay, and the claim is, assume that our set E contains both points A and B, preimages of minus zero and plus zero, and at least one of the point related to all other base points of the slits. And also it should contain at least one of the endpoints, left endpoint and draft endpoint of the comb. If so, then polynomial TN, which represented in terms of the conformal mapping, is extremal one on the given interval AB in the sense that any polynomial which is less than one on the set E also less than PN of X. And vice versa, if AB is a gap in the compact set E, and we are looking for the polynomial which is assumes the biggest point at any fixed point inside AB, then such polynomial can be represented as a conformal mapping on the comb domain, on a suitable comb with all mentioned above properties. The polynomial, in fact, does not depend on the point x0, but just depend on the given gap AB. I'd like to mention that, in fact, this technique, which represents extremal polynomial in terms of conformal mapping, is really nice and has many applications. And for example, we can give a solution, very simple, of the classical Remez problem formulated just for trigonometric polynomials. Sergei Tikhonov somehow convinced me that sharp Remez inequality for trigonometric polynomial was unknown. So if you have some ideas, I will be happy to know that it actually was solved before. Erdeli has a conjecture how should look like, which is right conjecture, how should look like the biggest possible estimation. So now I'm talking about standard Remez inequality, but just stated for algebraic polynomial Pn bounded by one on a certain subset on the unit circle. Okay, and then we have the following estimation, and we can write extremal polynomial explicitly in terms of Chebyshev polynomial. And to show this result, it's enough to know that extremal polynomials, like in the case of polynomial bounded on the real axis, can be represented in terms of have a comb representation, but in this case, comb should be periodic. So we consider certain configuration of described above time on the interval zero to pi, and then extend it periodically. And extremal polynomial on the real axis can be written in terms of this conformal mapping of the upper half plane on the periodic comb in these terms. In other words, extremal polynomial can be described for Remez, can be described in terms of conformal mapping of the unit disk on the unit disk with radial slits. And polynomial is bounded by one as soon as image is on the unit circle, and it is absolutely greater than one, and soon we are on the slits. Well, and to solve Remez problem for trigonometric polynomials or for polynomial bounded by one on a subsets of unit circle, we can use very, very simple observation related to monotonicity of harmonic measure. And to this end, let us mention two things. First of all, the biggest value of the polynomial in the gap alpha zero, beta zero is related to the length of this slit, which corresponds to this gap. So we have conformal mapping from this circle to this, and these intervals alpha, zeta, beta, zero, which we call gaps, they correspond to slits here. And alpha k, beta k corresponds to this slit, respectively. Okay. And this is about the biggest value. And what about the length of the set, which is we call E? This is nothing but harmonic measure of the unit circle with respect to the origin in these domains, in this slitted domain D. So now clearly, if I will make one of slits smaller, then harmonic measure of the unit circle in this domain will increase. Then I can make value F0 a little bit bigger so that my new domain has the same harmonic measure of the boundary like this one, but value is zero now is increasing. So therefore, making all additional slits smaller and increasing this value of a zero, I make evidently the biggest value larger and larger. So therefore, extremal configuration is just related to the case that we do not have any additional slits. And this is the proof of Remez inequality for trigonometric polynomials. Well, and I wanted to apply this kind of simple argument to with respect to Andreevsky problem, and then I recognized that it's hardly possible. And I'd like to provide the reason why I believe that this is most likely not possible. Let us consider quite simple object. I will consider interval of the length, gap of the length to delta, centered at alpha, and I will move alpha to the negative direction. For each particular alpha, we have a certain extremal polynomial, which assumes the biggest possible value in the gap. And according to general results, such polynomial should be of the one of these four mentioned here forms. It is evident that sometimes extremal polynomial is not of the biggest possible degree, but one less. For example, if we consider polynomial, extremal polynomial is the biggest possible value at the origin, then for the two symmetric interval, then such polynomial for sure should be even. And therefore degree of this polynomial is even. So if I give degree of polynomial odd, nevertheless, extremal polynomial still be even. That is of degree one less than the given one. So sometimes degree of extremal polynomial can be one less than the given degree. The given degree of polynomial is related to the difference between values n plus and n minus. And if h plus tends to infinity in the limit case, I will get a configuration in which we have polynomial of degree one less than difference between n plus and n minus. So let us start with this configuration. Assume that for certain alpha, we have extremal polynomial which correspond to h plus to infinity, and conformal mapping which describes such extremal polynomial is of this form. This endpoint corresponds to minus one, this endpoint corresponds to one, and left and right ends of the slit corresponds to alpha minus delta and alpha plus delta respectively. Then I start, so my goal is to modify somehow this domain in such a way that alpha will monotonically move to the right. So I'd like to indicate that interrelation between my parameter which describe comp and the simple parameters which describe domain are very non-trivial. Base always should be integer number, related to integer number. So what I'd like to show, I'd like to show how to change value n minus to value n minus plus one. Okay, so to do this, first I should move value of h plus smaller and smaller. As soon as this value h plus leave, get value zero, I have such things that now my in the limit position, I have that one corresponds to this point. After that, I can move the pre-image of one in this direction, and that end point as soon as which point has a value pn plus one. So now both end points of the comp corresponds to endpoint of the interval minus one and one. But I said that it is enough that just one of these two points is related to for extremal polynomial is enough for extremal polynomial. So since I have both points, I can start to move this point in this direction until it's reached pi minus one plus one. And after that, as soon as pre-image of minus one is here, I can start to move h minus up to plus infinity. So as a result, moving first down, then moving in this direction, then moving in this direction, and then moving up, I shift my original configuration of the comb just exactly by one in the right. The claim is that all this motion allows to move value alpha in this direction. But on the well, then I move this parameter h plus and h minus, I should move h zero in such way that the total length of the gap is constant to delta, because this is my condition on this gap here. So as a result, I should move these parameters using h zero such that the length of gap is always fixed. But during this, it appears that h zero can both increase and decrease. That's why I can see how using some probabilistic argument to find the moment at which I should switch from the case when h zero is increases to the case that h zero is decreasing. And that's why I do not believe that for Remez, for Andrievsky problem, we can find the similar simple solution as for Remez problem. Okay, what I said, this is a theorem and it can be proved using what we do. We use infinitesimal variations. So we have conformal mapping with in which we shift a little bit boundary. So this is a kind of Lerner chain in equation we did, and using this chains Lerner chains equation, we can prove that what I describe is indeed the true, how to move interval to the right. And our main part of our theorem, reduction to a single interval, also follows to this idea of using Lovner chain transformations. So via incidental transformations, we were able to prove our result. Now, as soon as we prove that extremal polynomial correspond to just one slit, we can think about asymptotics, how looks like asymptotic. And here we can at least explain how to do this with easy hints. So this is one of the possible extremal configuration for extremal polynomial, but I divide the whole picture by n. Then as a result, at least on the subsequences, this domain should converge to the domain of this kind. And domain of this kind is nothing but domain which correspond, conformal mapping which corresponds to such domain is nothing but domain which conformal mapping which is related to the Green function. So instead of the integer, we get here some omega, and this is well-known statement that Green function of the single interval can be represented as a, in terms of conformal mapping on the domain with a single slit. So this is the first term in asymptotic, how we can get a first term in asymptotics. Now, if we think about the second term of asymptotics, we can discuss this in this way. On one hand, difference, we have sometimes we have slits on the left or slits to the right that we discussed, extra slit. And in the limit, this boundary should approach to this boundary. And actually, like from the center of base, we have no data related to the limit behavior. But on the sense of height, we still have a certain value of h plus check as a limit of this height along subsequences. And in our consideration, we just use this fact that always we have some point here or here, possibly infinity, to get estimation of to get the Widom-Totic bound. But I'm quite believe that in fact, one can use such observation and to get explicit formula for the second term in asymptotics for Andreevsky constant. Now let's go back to Chebyshev-Ahiezer diagram, and I'd like to comment a little bit what's going on in transition from one kind of asymptotics to another kind of asymptotics. So the claim is that in the domain D and C, we have Remez kind, Chebyshev kind asymptotics behavior in domain between when x0 belongs to AB, we have asymptotics related to extremal Akiyezer polynomials. And this domain can be split into subdomains. So first, let us assume that x0 is in between zero and two delta minus one. In this case, the graph of the function jx0 depending of alpha in both endpoints is zero. Therefore, extreme point is for sure inside the interval, and therefore this is related to the case partial derivative with respect to alpha is zero, and consequently, for sure, we have a case that extremal polynomial is related to Chebyshev case. Now, as soon as value x0 is less than 2 delta minus 1, Then just one endpoint belongs to the main, but another point already, we have some non-trivial value of the green function at the second edge point. And therefore, extremal value is possibly assumed on the boundary of this interval for alpha, which I allow to consider. And therefore, extreme value is maximum between biggest possible value inside interval and biggest and the value of the function of the green function at the end point of the interval. By the way, starting from this moment, as soon as x0 less than this 2 delta minus 1, we also have not only extreme maximum, but also extreme minimum value inside the interval. And this is related to the second branch of our cube. So this point corresponds to minimum, where partial derivative of g with respect to alpha is zero. And this point corresponds to maximum, where partial derivative is greater than zero. But for a certain period in the this set B, we have the case that this value internal, maximum value is bigger than this on the boundary. And at certain moment, which we call switch point, this one, these two extremes are of the same height. And starting from the this switch point, the biggest value is also on the, now already is on the boundary. And therefore, we should switch from extremal Achiezer polynomial to extremal standard Chebyshev polynomials. And this happens up to the position x star delta, because it's this point is the point of inflection. Because now this extreme maximum and minimum approach to each other, and at this point, these two coincide. Therefore, the graph of the function became just monotonic starting from this point. And for all other x0 here, the graph of the function is just monotonic. Therefore, extreme value we get just on the boundary. And this that's why now we get that Chebyshev polynomial is related to the biggest possible value. Okay, so these are basically all possible behavior of extremal polynomials. And I'd like to use at least this Zoom format to drink for the Sasha's health. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, but don't drink too much. Maybe there is a question.
I should use a very small dose.
So any questions? Okay, Andrei, I expected your question. Yeah. Yes, you need. No, you should go. Go.
Ты можешь вот на камеру, вот на эту говорить. Peter, did I get it right that the optimal, hello once again.
Hi.
the optimal function for the Remez inequality is Chebyshev polynomial with just one gap, that is Zolotaryov polynomial.
It could happen that this is one gap, but it might be sometimes that this is internal gap, or it might be, this is the main part of the statement, indeed, that but this could be internal gap, or this could be like in the Remez extremal case that, in fact, we have Chebyshev polynomial.
But it's classical one.
Classical one.
Yes, yes.
And the main point, the main point actually to prove the result which you mentioned. But sometimes it could be that classical Chebyshev polynomial, if you see now on the, I show now this on the screen.
Yeah, and also I very much like your diagrams. I didn't know that they're Chebyshev Chiesser because I also draw a lot of diagrams like this. They correspond to changing something in the structure of extremal polynomials. Yeah.
I mean that it might be that there is some nice expression final This is a, exactly challenge to you. I mean, that maybe it's possible to give some theta function representation.
Yeah, right.
The problem with theta function representation deals with this unpleasant moment that point x0 related to alpha as a partial derivative is zero. So this is certain explicit equation. But I can see a way to solve it in a parametric way using theta functions.
Yeah, good, good. We had lots of problems of this kind appear also for optimal stability polynomial, but I will talk later about them, later today. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? I would like just to make a comment that it's in this session we have several talks which are around Chebyshev polynomials, and it's very, we should remember that just several weeks ago it was a 200 years anniversary of his birth. So this is, and we are very grateful to our participants that they give talks which remind us this nice event. So we have a 10 minutes walk, and there is a coffee, and someone is drinking wine in this nice morning. Yeah. So, and we should thank the speaker. Thank you.